Okay, so another month, another list. What is something that people in horror movies never seem to have with them whenever there's a killer nearby? A gun. Now, who carries guns wherever they are? Action heroes. Here's my top 10 favorite action movies. First off, number 10, we're going to get into a movie that knows it's stupid, or you know, that's probably up for debate, but Commando with Arnold Schwarzenegger. Oh, that sounded terrible. I'll perfect my Arnold impression, don't worry. Commando was made after Arnold did The Terminator, and basically he's playing Arnold Schwarzenegger. It doesn't matter if you give him a different name, it's Arnold Schwarzenegger. Or maybe coded also, but it's Arnold Schwarzenegger in every he's in. So basically this movie is over the top in its action. It has a lot of weird moments. Not weird, but a lot of goofy moments, like when Arnold pulls a seat out of the flight attendant's car, and when he's sitting down, he's like sitting like this in the car. Like, the flight attendant is up here driving. He's sitting like this. Huh? And if you saw The Nostalgia Critic, you know the joke that he made. One-liners, obviously. Remember Sully when I promised to kill you last? I lied. And, let off some steam, Bennett. I mean, it's just got so much over-the-top goofiness. A lot of action that's awesome. Because the movie sort of knows what it is, I go along for the ride, and it's pretty freaking awesome. It also has probably the weirdest score I've ever heard in any movie. I mean, what is this? I mean, it's not bad, it's just, you can't believe it's from James Horner, the same guy who scored Wrath of Khan, Titanic, Aliens, Avatar, and The Amazing Spider-Man. I mean, it sounds so... what? But, I mean, either the case, it adds to the film's weirdness, and yeah, Commando, number 10. Now, number 9 is a movie that would be a modern-day Commando if it was pumped up to 11. Like, it is absolutely nuts. And just to talk about this, I have warheads here that I'm going to eat while I talk about the movie. Because you need a crazy snack for a crazy movie. Crank High Voltage. Ooh. Whoa. This movie is nuts. I mean, it is so crazy. The editing's crazy. The camera work is crazy. It knows what it is, and it's just so... it's one of those movies that just says, fuck it. And that... sometimes it's bad, like Transformers. Sometimes it's good, like this. I mean, it's so crazy over the top. There's a random sex scene in the middle of a horse field. So much violence. Boobs, blood. A horse cock in the middle of that sex scene. Then my favorite part of the movie, there's this crazy Godzilla-like fight scene where Jason Statham and one of the guys he's fighting, it turns into a Godzilla movie also. They're in, like, costumes. Fighting around a power plant. The best part, there's two little workers that are just figures, and that is just so, like, what the fuck is happening? This is like, it's like Commando on crack. So crazy, so over the top, it's just so ass-kickingly awesome. I'm just freaking out over this movie, and these warheads are not helping. Oh, Sorry about that at first, but anyway, yeah, Crank 2 is really insane. It has a really energizing score, as you are hearing right now. It's just so awesome. But if this and Commando aren't the kind of action movies you like to watch, then pass them. I think something like the number 8 film would be more suited for you. And to prove that every movie on this list is not a crazy action movie like Commando or Crank, number 8 is First Blood. Probably the most unique action movie I've ever seen, and the only Stallone action movie that's going to be on this list. First Blood is the Rambo movie that's kind of overshadowed by the image that the general public has on Rambo. I mean, this movie has Rambo uses a lot of stealth. Only one person dies in this movie, and it's not because of him. It's mainly because of stupidity. It has a heart, something that the other Rambo movies lack. And it, when was there ever a time you saw an action hero cry in a movie? I mean, First Blood is really the only movie I can think of. I mean, it's a really, really good movie. Not a lot of emphasis on, like, really real action. A lot of stealth. And it's about the character of John Rambo. I mean, Stallone, this is probably his best performance, with the exception of Rocky. But, really good movie. Really heartfelt, gave us another iconic character, and First Blood, yeah. Number 7 is Christopher Nolan's Inception. I'm not sure if people really consider this an action movie, but I don't know, I do, and I think I've heard people say it's an artsy action film, or one big expensive art house film, but whatever. Inception, really, really, really good movie. It's got a lot of imagination to it. I love how Christopher Nolan utilizes the "you die in a dream, you'll wake up" thing. Like, I'm sure everyone has experienced that. Like, you die in a dream, you'll wake up. Like, I remember I had a dream where I was catapulted, fell off a cliff, then woke up when I hit the ground. I mean, really cool. It's also got really great performances. Leonardo DiCaprio, Tom Hardy, Marion Cotillard, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, the list goes on. The score is really good, but it can be very loud at times, like it is right now. There we go. And, I love the ending, how just, like, the top spins, cuts to black, just as it starts to wobble, and everyone in the audience goes, "Oh!" I mean, that got a huge laugh out of me when I saw it in the theater. And that is Inception. Really a masterpiece? Go see it if you're one of the few people that haven't. Now, you know how Arnold Schwarzenegger always said he'd be back? Well, he's back on this list in the number 6 spot, True Lies. This movie, a lot of people consider this to be James Cameron's least impressive movie. I personally prefer this over Titanic. I know that's a big thing to say, but that's hardly saying anything. Titanic is a masterpiece. This I just prefer because really a lot of fun. And, it's probably his first attempt at an actual action comedy. Schwarzenegger's obviously got the one-liners like, "Here, cool off," and, "May I see your invitation, please?" "Sure, here's my invitation." I mean, it's just stuff like that. I mean, I'm a big James Cameron fan, so obviously that amused me. It's funny. They can be a little annoying at times, and I think the scene where he gets his wife, played by Jamie Lee Curtis, to kind of like strip down, I think that's a bit cruel. But, looks like there's a scar right here, but whatever. I don't know, a lot of fun. Made me laugh a couple of times. especially when he makes his, like, escape, when he breaks loose of the handcuffs. I also like the line, "You kill people? Yes, but they were all bad. I mean, not much to say. I mean, if you haven't seen it, I recommend seeing it. I don't know, I can't guarantee if you like it or not, but I personally liked it enough to put it here, number 6. Number 5 is the only installment in this franchise that I have seen, and probably the best place to start. Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol. Like I said, I have not seen Mission Impossible 1, 2, or 3. And from basically from what I've heard of them, Mission Impossible 1 was fun, but it kind of could have been better. I heard 2 is god-awful, like unwatchable. I heard 3 was a great improvement, but still needed some work. And this one, people keep saying is the one they perfected. I wouldn't know, but this movie is a lot of fun. I mean, the chemistry between the teammates is really good. Paula Patton, Tom Cruise, Jeremy Renner, and Simon Pegg. It's got some great action sequences. It's probably one of the first movies I've seen in a while that during an action scene or something, I went, ugh! Like, kind of, like, creeped out. And I think a lot of that kind of has to contribute to the use of the IMAX camera. Because when I saw this in IMAX, I mean, I literally told my brother during the scene when Tom Cruise is climbing up the building, if I start to tip over, grab on to me. Because, I mean, like, looking, that shot where he's about to climb out and looks down and sees, and you see the bottom of the floor, it's just so, like, I mean, it's cringing at times, but still a lot of fun. Really happy Brad Bird made a successful transition into live action. Can't wait to see what he does, and I actually look forward to seeing the other movies, as well as whatever the future of this franchise holds. So, yeah, Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol, a lot of fun. Yeah. Sorry, I just wanted to hear the end of the theme. Now for number 4, Arnold Schwarzenegger is back. And this time he's being hunted by a predator. Yeah, I know, I had to take a stretch to come up with that intro, but can you blame me? Anyway, Predator, again, it's another Schwarzenegger movie, although with a different twist, in a way. Basically, like, every opponent that Arnold has had to face, with the exception... Okay, well... Only 2 opponents throughout his career have looked like they could stand a chance against him. One of which I'll get to later. Spoiler alert. And the other is the Predator alien. I mean, it's like, wow, Arnold has finally met his match against an alien who hunts for pleasure. It kind of works like kind of like a horror movie in a way. I mean, not scary at all, but the fact that the Predator is always watching Arnold and his team. He's picking them off one by one. I mean, yeah. I mean, the Predator looks really cool. It has some really cool action scenes. And, as you'd expect from a Schwarzenegger movie, a lot of great one-liners like, knock, knock, or stick around. And I'm sure everyone's favorite, you one ugly motherfucker. Or is everyone's favorite, if it bleeds, we can kill it. I don't know, pick your vote. Let me know in the comments which of those quotes is your favorite. And you even saw me quote Predator in my Rear Window review. I mean, Predator is just a fun time. It's not intellectual at all, but it really is one of the best action movies ever made. And not much to say about this except that Arnold will be back in this list. Number 3 is a movie that I don't have a piece of music to play to as I'm talking about the movie. It's more of a gangster movie than a action movie, I believe, or more of a crime movie. And I have no other reason. The Town. I originally had no intention to see this movie. I was like, Ben Affleck? You mean Michael Bay's bitch from Armageddon and Pearl Harbor? I know those were, like, years ago, but I... And then Daredevil, I mean, I just did not want to see it. And then I heard good things about it, and like, maybe I'll give it a shot. Maybe it will be good after all. So then I saw the movie, and I was like, wow, I didn't expect it to be this good, and I guess this means I can't make fun of Ben Affleck anymore. And that's really true. I mean, aside from starring in a really good role, he showed himself to be a really, really good director also. I mean, it's really intense. All the performances are great. Ben Affleck, Jeremy Renner, Rebecca Hall, John Hamm, and Blake Lively, who Ben Affleck managed to make someone as gorgeous as her look as skanky as she does in this movie, but, oh well. The action scene at the end of the movie is really, really intense, like, edge of your seat intense, especially between John Hamm and Jeremy Renner. Not much to say about this one, except that I plan to see Argo. I just haven't gotten around to it, but I will give a review for when I see it, and I'm really looking forward to seeing Argo. But, I mean, The Town, as it stands right now, The Town is really one of my favorite movies of all time. Really good. If you haven't seen it, I definitely recommend seeing it. Well, it didn't take long for Arnold to come back to this list, and what better movie to put in the number two spot than the movie that launched his career, The Terminator. I mean, it's very low budget for its time. It is overshadowed by its sequel, and it's very different from the future Terminator movies. There is a lot of action, but a lot of time it's very quiet, very atmospheric. It kind of has a creepy feel to it, in a way. Acting, obviously, is really good. I mean, this is the movie that basically launched Arnold's career, and it embedded in our minds that he is the Terminator. It's very... I mean, I mentioned it's kind of creepy at times. A lot of that has to do with the score. The score for the original Terminator has to be one of the creepiest scores I have ever heard, but it's really cool and it works to the film's advantage. Like Predator, it's not necessarily scary, but it would be a horror movie in a way, just like the Terminator is going around killing everyone named Sarah Connor until he tracks down the right one. And, I mean, Linda Hamilton's good as Sarah Connor, Michael Bean or Ben or whatever his name, last name is, as good as Kyle Reese. It has, like, a strong heart, and, just really, really a great movie. And, one-liners, obviously, like, Ice Night for a Walk, or Get Out. And the line that Arnold Schwarzenegger lives by in all of his movies, I'll be back. So yeah, original Terminator, very good, just a great movie. And now for number one. Number one movie, I mean, if you're one of my best friends, you already know what it is. And even if you're not, I've hinted at number one in this video. What could be better than the movie that launched Arnold Schwarzenegger's career as well as James Cameron's career? Terminator 2, Judgment Day. This is hands down my favorite action movie, and arguably the best sequel ever made for any movie at all. I mean, like how people thought The Predator was Arnold's match. The T-1000 in this movie, first-time viewers would look at it and go, Arnold could beat that thing to a pulp. But no, it's actually very deceiving because it's actually stronger than Arnold, the Terminator, is. And that was a brilliant move by James Cameron, not making Arnold's opponent bigger, but actually smaller than him, and making him more powerful. I mean, aside from that, it's got really good performances again. I'm not even going to say what the one-liners in this movie are, because everyone knows them. The moral of the movie is like, it's sort of like Back to the Future's moral of the future is whatever you make it. This one, like, there's no faith for what we make for ourselves. We're in control of the future. And that's a great message for an action movie like this, and especially a big budget one. The T-1000 is really a cool villain, especially with all of his liquid metal abilities. Really a great theme. I mean, I already talked about the future deciding theme, but music theme in general is just really good. I mean, I don't want to talk about this movie too much because, I mean, if you're one of the stupid people right now watching this video or doing something else, right now you are wasting your time. Put down whatever you're doing, unless it's really, really urgent. Put down whatever you're doing, go rent or buy Terminator 2, sit down, and watch it. It is really one of the best movies ever made, and hands down, my favorite James Cameron movie, my favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movie, and my favorite action movie of all time.